them as they ring around the world, celebrating Christmas carols from far-off lands and different cultures. You just heard the familiar Carol of the Bells from the Ukraine. Now, what a more fitting way to open our concert with Adeste Fideus, or as we know it, O Come All Ye Faithful. The words and music with which we are familiar are attributed to John Wade and first appeared in England as a hymn in 1743. So now come, rise as you are able, and lift your voices as we sing, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Thank you.
may not, off the top of your head, be able to name a Christmas carol from Scotland or Ireland. At just the right time, we accidentally stumbled over our next selection, Celtic Christmas Jig, and hoped it just might fit well in tonight's program. We think you'll agree it does. Although the title includes the word jig, we want you to know that there are actually two Christmas jigs in this piece. The first is an authentic Scottish jig jig. And listen for something that sounds a bit like a bagpipe, and then try to keep your feet still while that's going on. And the second Celtic Christmas jig is from Ireland and entitled Bottom of the Punch Bowl. We'll leave that interpretation to your own imagination. Thank you. Jeannette Isabella, originated in the Provence region of France in the 17th century. As our flautist, Gert Young and Peggy Wallace take their places, listen to how the Nativity story was imagined by French children.
Bring a torch, Jeannette Isabella. Bring a torch to the stable, run. Christ is born, good folk in the village. Christ is born and Mary's calling. Oh, beautiful is the mother. Oh, beautiful is the son.
It is wrong when the child is sleeping. It is wrong to talk so loud. Silence now as you gather around, lest your noise should waken Jesus. Hush, hush, see how he slumbers. See how fast he sleeps.
Who is that knocking on the door? Who is knocking like that? Open up. We've arranged on a platter lovely cakes that we have brought here. Open the door for us. Let's celebrate.
Glory to God in the highest.
It was in the moon at wintertime, fled. The mighty Gitche Manitou sent angel choirs instead. Before their light, the stars grew dim, and wondering hunters heard the hymn. Jesus, your King is born, Jesus is born, in excelsis gloria.
The Huron Carol demonstrates how the Jesuits set the Christmas story to one of their native songs to interpret the birth of Jesus to the Hurons. Carl Wilksy, the handbell arranger, added the sound of distant drums.
Within a lodge of broken bark, the tender babe was found, a ragged robe of rabbit skin, and wrapped his beauty round. The chiefs from far before him knelt, with gifts of fox and beaver pelt. Jesus, your King is born, Jesus is born, in excelsis gloria.
Good evening. My name is Tom Feller, and I happen to be a member of the board of the Lancaster Handbell Ensemble.
I didn't think I'd hear the microphone, but I guess Linda thinks I do. My name is Tom Feller. I happen to be president of the board of the Lancaster Handbell Ensemble. If I could start by just saying thank you for coming to see our concert this evening. And we certainly hope you enjoy all that we have to present to you this evening. I know I am enjoying it immensely. I'm always impressed when I hear the programs that they put together. As a board, one of our primary functions is to raise financial resources for the organization. Briefly, if I could just ask you to take a look in your program, there are a couple ways that I'd like to point out to you so that you can be aware of, that you can help support the organization if you're not already. So in the back, you will find information about becoming a sponsor. You can sponsor your own name and a loved one's name at different levels. It's a great way to support the organization. And I think the other one I want to mention to you is the Kroger campaign that we are a participant in. If you use a Kroger card when you go to grocery shopping, which many of us do, you can just swipe your Kroger card and we receive donations from it. It doesn't cost you a dime. Doesn't affect your fuel points, trust me. I know my wife has let me know that it doesn't affect our fuel points. We raise money for lots of different things. It's the music that we have, it's the maintenance and insurance on the bells, it's the table decorations that you see, the stand lights. I could go on and on and on. I think equally as important would be the scholarships that we provide. And we've been fortunate over the past 4 years, as I understand, to be able to give scholarships here to music students who are in their junior year or higher, majored in music in some form. Doesn't have to be music education, doesn't have to be music performance. So this year, we were able to give out two $1,000 scholarships. One is to Andrew Rebo, who is a student at James Madison University. Andrew's not here this evening. The other is Corey Burrow, who is a senior at Ohio University. Corey was supposed to be here. We were planning on him to be here, but traffic and the weather has held him up. Just as important as Corey, though, is Corey's mother. So I'm going to just walk back here and ask her to stand. Let's give her a round of applause.
We couldn't resist sneaking in an additional French carol for the extraordinary energy and hope its music added to the meaning of the word Noël. It's been said that Noël originally meant now all will be well, and a joyous response to the birth of Jesus. Sing we now of Christmas. Sing Noël. Noël. Sarah Bloom. We welcome oboist Josh Harkins, as we offer what is considered by many to be one of the most peaceful melodies and lush harmonies among Christmas hymns. Enjoy the calmness of spirit evoked by "Lo, How a Rose e'er Bloomed." We were not able to uncover the actual words, but it's delightful. So rhythm is sure to recall warmer weather, turquoise water. You can feel the sun on your face and the sand between your toes. Welcome our percussionists back as they prepare to add to the Calypso feel of the West Indies Christmas.
I feel obligated to add a little bit to that, because after our first concert earlier today, people came up to me afterwards and said, there were words to that. Harry Belafonte sang it. And another person said, I taught school music and it was in our school music book. And another person just remembered singing it. I promise, I searched the internet. There was another piece called West Indies Carol. It had different words that didn't fit with this tune. So, mea culpa, I have erred in some way, but I think you're going to enjoy it anyway.
Thank you.
but in the Spanish poem, Riu, Riu, Chiu, apparently represents a warning call of a kingfisher, which could be a metaphor for God protecting the Virgin Mary from the devil. The list of those who recorded this exhilarating Spanish Christmas carol is quite extensive, impressive, and we won't list them all for you today, but we'll share just two. The Kingston Trio, wait for it. Wait for it, Kurt. The Monkees. Not a version we'll do here. Seriously, kidding aside, Riu Riu Chiu is considered one of the most popular tunes of the Renaissance, which ran from 1450 to 1600. Now, percussion, flute, and bells together present Riu Riu Chiu.
Christmas Day, we have old familiar carols to play. in music sweet, the words repeat of peace on earth, goodwill to men. I thought how as the day had come, the belfries of all Christendom had rolled along the unbroken song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And in despair, I got my hand. There is no peace on earth, I said, for hate is strong and mocks the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Then pealed the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor doth he sleep, for Christ is here, his spirit near, brings peace on earth, goodwill to men.